Hello children, welcome back. And today in decimals we will be solving sums from the mixed bag. Okay, so let us start. Yashvi weighs 57.7 kg, while her sister weighs 59.02 kg. How much more does Yashvi's sister's weigh than her? That means here they have given the weight of Yashvi and they have given the weight of sister, and you can see the weight of sister is more. This is 59 and this is 57. So they have asked how much more does Yashvi's sister's weigh. That means they have asked what is the difference between them. So how will we write? We will write Yashvi weighed 57.7 kg. See here children, how to place the decimals properly. And sister's weight is 59.02. Now because we have to find the difference, so we will write sister's weight on the top, okay, and then we will write Yashvi's weight. So sister's weight is 59.02 kg and Yashvi weight is 57.7 kg. Now see children, the decimal should be correctly placed below the decimal, okay. So decimal and decimal should come correctly, one above the other. So 57.7 kg. So after the point, the 7 will come, and before the point, 7 and 5. So you can see the decimals have been placed correctly. Now here, if there is no number, you can place a 0. Okay. So let us find the difference. 2 minus 0 is 2. Then borrow. 10 minus 7 is 3. 8 minus 7 is 1. And difference is 1.32 kg. So you can say Yashvi's sister weighs 1.32 kg more than Yashvi. So this is your final answer. Okay. So let us go to the next sum. A motor pumps out 6704.55 liters of water from a tank in 1 hour. That means in 1 hour, a motor pumps out so many liters of water. How many liters of water will it pump in 4 hours? So let us write down the information. First, this sentence. So liters of water pumped in 1 hour. How much is that children? 6704.55 liters. Therefore they have asked us how many liters of water will it pump in 4 hours. So hours to keep below hours we have to write 4. So in 4 hours, how many liters of water will be pumped out? So I told you children, if you have confusion whether this particular sum is a multiplication or a division, you can use the cross multiplication method. Now if you see, 4 and 6704.55 is in the cross way. So this is multiplication, and what is remaining has to be divided. Anything divided by 1 is the answer itself. So best is to multiply this. So they have given information about 1 and asked for many. So we will multiply. So the answer for this will be 6704.55 multiplied by 4. So 4 5s are 20, 4 5s are 20 plus 2, 22, 4 4s are 16 plus 2, 18, 4 0s are 0 plus 1, 1, 4 7s are 28, 4 6s are 24 plus 2 is 26. So in 4 hours, how many liters of water is pumped out? 26818.20 liters of water will be pumped out. So you understood children, if you write this information correctly, one below the other, you will can easily find out whether it is a case of multiplication or a division. So let us go to the last sum. If the cost of dozen cups, now you know children what is one dozen. One dozen means it is 12, right? So if the cost of a dozen cups is 182.40, what is the cost of each cup? So let us write, instead of writing cost of dozen cup, I will write, instead of dozen cups, I will write here 12 cups. So cost of 12 cups is 182.40. So cost of 12 cups is equal to 182.40. What is the cost of each cup? So each means one. So cost of each cup means one cup. So here also we can do the trick of seeing whether it is multiplication or division. 1 into 182.40 is 182.40. What is remaining, children? 12 is remaining. So it is a case of division, because they have given information about many and they have asked about one. So 182.40 divided by 12. 12 ones are 12. Bringing 2 down, 62. 12 fives are 60. Subtraction, remainder is 2. Now before bringing 4 down, there is a decimal in the dividend place, which we will place it in the quotient. So 12 twos are 24. And now when I bring this 0 down, it is nothing but 12 zeros are 0. And our remainder is 0. That means we have derived at the answer. So the cost of one cup, this is the quotient. So the cost of one cup is ₹15.20. Hope you understood that, sums, children, whether it is a case of multiplication or division. There is two more sums to go, which we will see in the next lecture. Bye.